there's a lot of great people. And our campground was a couple of guitar players.
Yeah. talking about.
So I realized my daughter is playing with the capo, and I think it must be lost in the bus somewhere. But that's okay. We'll just make sure not to play any songs with capos on them, or if they are, we're going to change the key on the spot.
I'm going to go find it.
Are you sure?
Yes.
All right.
I can't believe that you actually thought that you said that.
So Emily's going to go look for a capo because she is awesome. You're so great, Emily. Look at you go. I want to do a really fun jazz standard that I only get to do when Emily leaves. So,
did you check the guitar case?
Let's find out. Let's do that first.
I'm not going all the way out there until we looked at the guitar case. $20. All right, who bets that it's not the guitar case? I have $20 in it.
It's not.
These two people over here, we got Joe and Mindy in the crowd, and they also travel full time like we do in like a van. So it's out there. It's got like solar panels on the top, kind of like our bus does.
So if you're gonna go slashing tires, don't do this because they're really nice.
Yeah, they're great. But I always think of like our van life friends when we sing that verse where it says going places that we've never been, or no, seeing places that we'll never see again, or something. Was that like?
I don't remember.
Anyway, and it's like, that's our life. We have no idea if we're going to see this place again. And so.
I think we'll come back here, though.
We'll definitely come back here. We love Kansas. I love Kansas. I will say, though, when I tell people that, they look at me like I'm crazy, but.
I could do without the tornado thing, personally. I'm from Missouri, and we do get a lot of tornadoes there, but they're not as big, usually, except for that one. We were just in Greenford yesterday, which had the second largest tornado in global history, and it like destroyed their whole downtown. Like, that was crazy. And they have this ice cream shop now, and they have this thing where it's 40 scoops of ice cream, and if you eat it all, then it's free, and they call it the EF5. And I was like, is it too soon? It's not too soon for that? Okay. I hate tornadoes. Do you guys have basements out here?
Good.
In Tennessee, they get tornadoes, but they don't have basements because it's all like rock. Like they can't like dig into the earth or something. They're like, all right, put that on my list of places I'm never living.
No one cares.
These guys care. Your tornado alley is moving east.
You got sick of the cold, the humidity.
No, it's
moving east.
It's moving east.
Oh.
Yeah, it is.
It heard the beach. Heard the beaches.
Anyways, what did you want to say? Let's do it. Alright, so here's a song that we wrote about this stupid guy that we know. I'm just kidding. He's here, that's why I said that. Sorry. That was only funny. No, we wrote the song about a really cool dude who has flown and driven out to some crazy places to hang out with us, support us, and just like be an awesome friend. He's also streamed our songs way more times than I am willing to admit because I want people to think that we got those streams organically. But it's mostly Phil. So we wrote him a song. Kind of like just a little tricky. And we wrote it when we were in Utah together. The song is called Utah.
Tell me I'm finding more than you.
so that we can just see the disco ball. And then we made it.
Hear the train coming, no one is rolling down the bed.
It's like, how come you guys never ever yell my name when I come here? You always go, no, or but you never say anything when I walk in. And they're like, okay, fine, go outside and try again. So she walks out and she comes back in and they all yell, Norm! So funny. Good
times. He's literally watched that show like probably 15 times in the last couple of years. That's all he ever thinks about.
It's a good show. I'm on the episode right now where Sam and Diane buy a house together. And you know what happens after that.
Yep, it's almost the end.
Here comes Rebecca.
Alright, back to music now. Here's a song we wrote called Arcadian that you can also find on the CD over here. This one is a lot longer than the one that we just played a minute ago from the CD. Almost like 3.5 minutes longer. The other one was only 26 seconds.
I was gonna say, if you're really confused about what she just said, and you're afraid we're gonna play an 8-minute song.
We're not gonna do that. We're all good here. This song was written in upstate New York in the Adirondacks. Anybody know what the Adirondacks are? Well, for those of you who don't know, it's a 6-million-acre forest in upstate New York. And it's beautiful. It's full of cute little towns. That's where Shane Tom is from. He's only half Canadian.
75%, I would say, because my dad's Canadian.
It's got blood, Shane.
No, it's not.
Yes.
And I was actually born in Canada. Never even saw the States until 21. That makes me 75% at least, I would think.
I disagree. Do you think it's by blood? Thank you. Alright, let's play this song.
7%.
Our kids are only a quarter Canadian today.
No, because it's 5 blood. Oh, because you're saying that I'm
going to be. If they ever started a band, it should be called Quarter Canadian. That'd be a good one.
Or Loonies and Toonies.
We'll definitely have a band.
Yes. Loonies and Toonies. Hey, fun fact. Okay, you guys want to learn some fun facts?
Sure.
Okay. Fun fact, in Canada, they don't have $1 and $2 bills. They have coins, and they're called loonies and toonies. Just to give us another reason to make fun of them.
Yeah, they say, you can already take our country seriously. Well,
there you go.
And there's also hockey players on our $5.
Also, another fun fact about Canada, the national sport of Canada is lacrosse.
Oh,
time, folks. So $10 today. I want to say that specifically this one time someone said, oh, that was just a joke, and they walked away with like 5 free CDs, and they just...
I thought that we were giving them away for free.
But, I mean, if you didn't have any money and you wanted one, we'd still give it to you. It's just so you know. So just tell us that you're super poor and show us your, you know, show us your bank statements and it's yours. Just kidding. So, okay, so I see people with cameras out there, like long lenses, small lenses. Is there like a, I don't know anything about cameras. Is like the longer the lens, like the bigger, the better? Is that the thing?
Sometimes.
Because I'm going to show
sometimes
up.
Size matters.
Because I'm going to show up to a venue one day with people with cameras. So I'm just going to make sure I find a lens, even if it's like a $3 lens from like a, what do you call that thing? Like the children's toys?
Play school
or something? It's going to be like this long. People are going to be like, that's right.
Okay, so this next song, can you just say yes? Trust me.
I have no idea what she
can
wants to
play. Can you please just trust me? We have to do it.
I mean,
yes.
I don't trust you, but you know, I'll do anything. So.
Okay. We never, ever, ever do this song because we wrote this back when we were Shane and Emily, but we wrote it the last time we were here. So, and we have to do it for Mindy and Joe. So, a few years ago, we were driving through Kansas in the middle of the night in our RV that we lived in at the time, and we hit a deer. And it was just off the highway here. And so we pulled into a mechanic that was nearby so that he could check it out in the morning. But while we were waiting for a tow truck, because at the time we thought we needed one, we sat down, we made some chili in the RV, we wrote a song about it, and we recorded it and released it under the band name Shane and Emily. We're going to play it right now because, I mean, if we were ever going to play it somewhere, it's right here.
It's going to be here.
This song is called Life Goes On.
That deer's family is here somewhere.
He's at the pond just where like the bar was like all the way around, and it was like a grand piano.
There's one right here.
And yeah, that was really fun in there, Emily. No, it's not dirty.
It's fun?
It's fun. You'll see why.
Are there dolls in there?
No, what? Oh man, I watched one of the other. Alright, so this next song I would play all the time. So, Mom, if you're watching on YouTube, this song goes out to you because I know you like this. And I hope you guys do too. And if you know the song, don't sing along. Just kidding. Totally sing along.
Okay, that's not bad.
We have to put that hand down.
something one time that I thought was interesting. It said, being a mom is like jumping out of an airplane with a bunch of people who don't know how to open their parachutes. So you go around opening their parachutes for them, and then you don't have enough time to open your own parachute, but when you hit the ground, you don't die. You just get up and make dinner. All you moms out there, you're tracking with me, yes? Way before I do. So I definitely get more sleep than him.
so funny. I remember we played a show once, and someone said, "That's my favorite song that you guys did all night long." And I was like, "Oh, thanks." I was like feeling good. You know, that's a nice compliment. And I was like, "Wait a second, I'll sing on that song."
Well, so you did. I'm just kidding.
I did take it.
No. Okay. Should we do Dear Prudence now, or should we space it out?
Let's space it out.
Okay. How about some Michael Jackson?
What's that?
How about some Michael Jackson?
Do you guys like Michael Jackson? Is this a Michael Jackson crowd? We're gonna play a folky version of Michael Jackson.
We're gonna make this a Michael Jackson crowd.
We're gonna try. It's so funny when we ask questions.
As long as it's
like
been.
That. What's that?
As long as it's been the early years.
Yeah, I think it is. So, you know what's funny? We ask questions like this all the time, like, "Hey, do you like this artist?" As if we're not gonna play it.
Yeah, no matter what you say, we're gonna do it anyway.
You know what I mean?
I did one time, we were at Silver Dollar City. I was like, "How do you guys feel about us doing a folksy version of a Michael Jackson song?" And a lady in the crowd was like, and I was like, "Well, we're gonna play it anyways." We did, but she was totally tapping her toe by the end of that song.
We called her out and we said, "Listen, man."
Anyways, we'll take a poll after we play this song to see how people. Is that a Casey's pizza? We're back in the land of Casey's. Breakfast pizza from Casey's? Breakfast pizza from Casey's is my favorite. I wanted it for my birthday so bad I never got it.
There's a reason I still remember what it was.
It was because we had.
Who knows? What was the reason?
We had.
I was just going to say, you know, that's going to be one of the bus in the morning, right?
Because you weren't at the bus, it's true. If you were there, I would have gotten it. It was because we got free breakfast sandwiches from the coffee shop. Which was honestly better. Thank you. the first one, I'll be like, I always feel like somebody's watching me. I got no privacy because I got two kids. And then I'm like, I always feel like somebody's watching me. Oh, even when I pee. Well, I didn't know if you were that kind of crowd. Okay, you are good to know.
She's judging you guys just by looking at you.
I'm trying to be respectful, okay?
My goodness. Emily, they're people too, come on. So, just because they're from Kansas, come on, man. Are you guys all from Kansas?
Yeah.
Like you all from here?
Clap your hands if you're from Kansas. Oh, thank you.
And we're all in the
Wait a minute.
I honestly, Kansas is one of my favorite states. So they just lived up. I think it's like the... epitome of peace. You know what I mean? Like, you just come here, it's just like, every time I drive through Kansas, I just feel peace. That's all I feel. No matter where I go, I feel safe.
Except for the deer.
Those tornadoes. I don't know what he's talking about. Deer, tornadoes.
Listen,
there's no trees.
I'm talking about the people, okay?
I still love it here, though.
It's the only place where you walk in and someone says, like, oh, hey, you're not like, who? What? What do you want from me? Anyway, by the way, sorry that while we're singing, we're not like talking to you guys. We played the show once where someone told us, like, you need to, like, look your audience in the eyes as you perform. And I'm like, I get where they're coming from, and maybe for some people that works, but there's something awkward I can't get out that's just being like, wise men say, just like saying.
Do you like that?
Do you like that? I can't do it. But I can talk to you and look at you, but I can't. Anyway.
Should we do the other Beatles song?
We should do that one. Let's just do the one I just sang. We're going to do it for him.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to sing it right in your face the whole time.
Okay, sounds good. This song
is
for all you lovers out there, but don't worry. If you stick around, we got something for the haters, too. There's no haters in here. Thank you.
gosh. And if you want, you can find that on our YouTube channel. Hey, Phil, any fun comments on there? Any requests? Sometimes they got some really good ones. Sometimes they don't.
No requests. Someone's digging Emily's pants.
Someone's digging Emily's pants.
I just got these, and I'm pretty excited.
I just noticed.
Yeah, so our 3-year-old, like, after I put them on, he was just following me around the bus going like this. He's like, those are so cozy.
He never said that about my pants.
I went for, like, the 70s look today. My earrings match my shirt. I'm going to wear this every day for the next week. Hey, let's do Dear Prudence.
All right.
And then we'll do an original. No, let's do an original, then we'll do Dear Prudence.
Also, it could totally be any time right now. I'm just having such a good time. I don't care. I'm going to guess it's 7:52.
I'm going to guess it's 7:40.
7:34. Is that what time it is?
Yep. We still got time, folks.
I don't remember how long I'm supposed to play.
Till 8.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So we got like 15 more songs for you guys.
Here's a song that we wrote.
Just kidding, that's not true.
No.
Fireflies?
I said let's do an original first.
Oh, original first, cool. Hey, I like this song.
Shay wrote this song. Do you guys have fireflies here?
Yes.
You're like in the part of Kansas that gets them, because it's only a couple hours west of here that it's like dry as a bone, right? Because it was dry where we camped last night, and then today I was like, my skin is wet again.
We were
in Greensburg. There's this park there, and we were just hanging out there with the kids, and then I was looking over and I was like, those look like RV hookups. And I looked online, and it's a free campsite with RV hookups. And I was like, what? So we stayed. It was great. I miss the dry air a little bit. I do like the dry air.
I was going to say also, my
mom would like to hear Mary yelling.
Pretty sure I got wet.
Who requested that?
Your mother.
My mom.
Aww, Emily's mom's watching everybody.
Mom.
Everybody at the same time say, hi, Emily's mom.
Hi, Emily's mom.
You guys are really good at that.
Yeah, that was amazing. She requested a song that we wrote that we have played on like 2 times live, and we're really bad at it. Mom!
But we'll totally do it for mom, because when mom's asked for something, you do it.
I'm not ready for it right now, though.
No, we're going to do the song first.
Mom. My mom's the best. No, and nobody asked for it.
Oh, I saw that on
there. We're not happening.
No. Oh, I almost said it.
Thank you.
Oh, the mayor.
We'll see if we can remember how to play this. So
it's the lyrics that I have. If you have them on your phone, I can probably wing it. But
so I wrote this song a few years ago because I read a book. Has anybody read Jamaica Inn or like watched the movie or the series? It was written in like the 40s, I think.
I got the other one stuck in my head.
That sounds right. But it was just, I just wrote about like the story because it was a really good book, and I don't know, I write like one song by myself like per year, and this was one of them. And Shane liked it, and we didn't have anything like that, so I was like, ah, whatever. And we literally have played it like twice. I don't think I have the lyrics, though.
Look online, I still want to put them online.
Really? Okay, let's see.
I think I can fake.
Oh,
Like, you know, the Titanic? Would you dance if I asked you to dance? Those two songs would go together really well. Yeah. Just saying. It'd be the worst cheesiest match of all time.
I like cheese though. It's my favorite.
Thank you.
thank you so much for hanging out and being here and just being such. This was a fun.
This was the best VFW show we've ever done.
Ever.
It might have been the only one we've ever done.
But still,
so now our expectations are high if we ever do one again.
Next time someone says, "Hey, you want to play with the VFW?" I'm like, "Yes."
Absolutely.
Because the last one was so great. You guys ever?
You just
shut off the air conditioner. I don't else hear that.
Yeah, that was kind of weird.
That's weird. I don't believe in coincidences. Anyway, so we're Arbor Season. Please feel free to follow us on all social medias. We have a book over here. If you want us to come back to Kansas, all you have to do is sign our book. It means that we're going to come play in your living room next time we come to town. Or at least reach out to you and say, hey, if you want to host us, you can. But you can either say, not right now, this is a bad time. Or, yeah, that'd be great. Or you can say, please never email me.
we get all three.
It's always humorous when people say, please don't email me anymore. And I'm like, will you sign up? But that's okay. All right.
Hey, they have a tip jar up here to help them with all this gas that they're having.
Oh,
we want to say thanks so much to Mike for helping us get all of these shows.
We have so many shows here, and like we've never really played in Kansas before, and we're just coming here, we're going to do all this, and it's like the greatest thing ever. This is like our dream. So.
Yeah, we get to hang out in one spot. Woo, woo, woo. Woo. He's like, my name's not Mike, but thank you. what are we doing? Oh yeah, of course.
Do you want to do that? Yeah, let's do it. How many times are we going to do that
with the show ends?
He does. I was like, what's about
to happen? I thought if I ever go solo, which I won't, but if I ever did, I'm going to have behind me, literally, I think I've decided, I'm going to have a dresser, like a full-on dresser, full of like random objects that I'll play the piano with like throughout my show. Like I'll pull out like a stuffed animal and like try to do a solo with a stuffed animal, like weird stuff like that.
Don't go solo.
No. Just
keep
doing.
Don't hear the angel.
Oh man. All right, here's a song for you. Thanks for being here, everybody. We hope to see you again. And hey, if you follow us on YouTube, we're gonna literally try to do most of these shows.
That was like a moment that would have been in tears. That was like perfect comedic timing, man. That was great.
Was. You sneezing and the air conditioner going off and we got Norma over here. This is great. We'll
call you Norma.
Norma.
Well, she was standing in the bar. I said, hello, how do you do? She handed me a beer with a candle. She spoke of places I had never. That she had traveled to and slow dance along fast and
it's kind of
a minute past, a minute left, should have marked my middle range, she said.
That's pretty cool. Classy girls from kissing bars, you fool. I gotta say, I didn't write this song, so I didn't make this rule. I say kiss all you want.
So
Yeah.